Hi, my name is Thuy Nguyen with the Vietnamese American Television. I have the honor to interview Mr. Thuy Nelson. She's a pre-licensed therapist, and I'm going to let her introduce herself so I don't mess it up. Thuy, please take a few minutes and introduce yourself to our audience.
Hello, my name is Thuy Nelson, and I am a resident in counseling here in Virginia. I currently work at a practice called Healthy Minds Therapy, and I specialize in trauma work, family work, and I see children as well. Anyone with mental health difficulties and challenges that need support.
Hi, Thuy. I want to go back to when a person is diagnosed with a condition, or we call it, let's say, a disease. How does a person get referred to you, or how does he or she seek you out for your services?
Usually, the person would notice these symptoms for themselves and self-refer to our practice and ask to see a clinician. And then the practice would reach out to me, and or they would just look at my schedule and fill in the spot where I have an opening. The nice things about in the US is that everybody have somewhat more awareness about mental health. So they have the information they need to be able to self-refer and see those symptoms in themselves.
And these persons or person, they are referred to you through your affiliation with the hospitals, with physicians, and with other therapists or other professionals?
Yes, there are cases when other patients that have been hospitalized in, you know, other programs that demand a higher level of care, if they transition out of those programs, inpatient or outpatient, their physicians would refer them to our practice, which is the lowest level of care, just for a smoother transition back to their normal lives.
And I'm sure you specialize in many different areas of mental health. In a few, you know, kind of sentences, can you summarize your, let's say, 3 to 5 major areas where you get the most requests to help?
So some of the very common areas that I get requests from is depression, anxiety, trauma, and I also have postpartum depression, just for women that have go through, you know, pregnancy and just recently had baby. I also have other areas as like marriage and family work, where communication is limited or have communication challenges between the partners. Those are some of the areas that I get the most requests in.
And I also noticed reading your summary or bio that you have mentioned, or you mentioned in the in your bio, that these insurance companies will pay for some of these services, and your private therapy sessions is charged by the hour. And my question is, how does a person submit a claim to the insurance company, or how does that person get a pre-approval for your services?
That question, so usually a person would contact their insurance company to know their benefits first. Okay. And once they know how much their insurance cover for mental health benefits, they can reach out to our office. I don't handle the insurance side myself. We have an insurance specialist on our team that would be able to answer those questions, whether we are in network with the client's insurance company, or how many sessions the clients are entitled to, as far as service go, those questions our insurance team can answer and help the clients with.
Let me go back to what you had said you have the most practice in the area of depression. How does a person know he or she is depressed, or how does one admit to that condition to seek out help? And the second part of that question is, just in general, how do you talk to a person in that condition and help them transition into a kind of a better life, or to get out of the depression? Just general answers. You don't have to be specific.
Okay. So generally speaking, if you notice yourself have diminished interest in just regular tasks or activities that you usually enjoy, you are noticing yourself feeling a lot of the negative feelings like sadness, feeling really sad, and feel just less interest in a lot of activities, or you feel like you just stuck and don't know where to go next. Those are some of the general symptoms that you sleep a lot, or you don't sleep enough. Those are some of the symptoms that you should seek out mental health specialists to work with you. And what we usually do is we would listen, first of all, and make sure that you feel supported and you are the best. We believe that you are the best author of your stories, of your life. You have the best understanding of yourself, and we just kind of be there alongside with you, making sure help you to navigate through that chapter of your life, figure out what is best to do in that situation.
And in general, not any particular case, in general, how many sessions do you think a depressed person need to go through with you, or in general with a professional, to, you know, resolve that issue within himself or herself?
In general, we usually suggest that you attend therapy for 3 months, once a week, for the best therapeutic progress and result. So that's about 12 to 15 sessions.
One more thing, and I also read that you have a specialty dealing with Asian people in general. Can you name a few challenges that Asian people are facing that cause their mental health to be in balance, or that cause them to seek out help from yourself or other professionals?
One of the main reasons that I have seen is just the cultural challenges. We come from a very different culture. To be able to adjust to the American culture and also meet the pressure from our families, the expectations that we have from families and from our just social group in a whole, can really cause that imbalance in a person's mental health, because they feel like they don't understand what it is that they need to do. And there's a misunderstanding and an imbalance between themselves and the expectation of others.
One last question regarding addictions to, number one, alcohol and drugs. How do you handle those cases, and are these patients kind of violent, or are they normal people like a person with a mental health issue?
There are various cases when it comes to substance abuse. There are, you know, people that just have very mild symptoms, but there are also those that need further treatment, where we would refer out to different programs, day programs, or programs where they would stay on site for a long period of time, the inpatient treatment program, in another word. So what happens if we would just assess them with different tests and measurements to see where they're at, and also via talk therapy and observing them, their behaviors, to know where they're at and decide what to do next.
And to wrap up, I would like to thank you for your time. And we learned a lot today, and hopefully our audience will learn a lot more about the current mental health challenges that we face, and come to a realization that we need help and we need professional help. And that's when you come in. And Thuy, thank you very much. And please say goodbye to our audience.
Thank you very much for your time. And please reach out if you feel like you or your loved one needs some support, because you are not alone, and we are in this together.
Thank you.
Thank you.